Today we will be giving you step-by-step instructions on how to do a real-life cutting throat effect. For your actor's neck, you will need liquid latex, face makeup. For our purposes, we're using gray, but you will probably need a skin tone. Makeup application tools. And fake blood. Now for the materials you will need for your actual effect. A garden sprayer. Clear plastic tubing. Air tube connectors. Zip ties. Heat shrink tubing. A 2-liter bottle. And baby powder. And don't forget some household materials like a Sharpie, scissors, glue, and tape.
So first, you want to take your 2-liter bottle and you want to secure it so it won't move. Take your Sharpie and draw a layout of your actor's neck. But remember, it shouldn't be bigger than 3 inches, top to bottom. Once you have completed that, you'll need about 8 layers of liquid latex in the layout that you did with your Sharpie. By applying each layer onto the area, let it dry in between coats.
Use your scissors and carefully cut a slash in the middle of your latex mold to create the scar.
Before you place your latex mold on your actor's neck, connect one end of your heat shrink tubing to one of your tube connectors and make sure it's secure so that no liquid will leak through.
Then, cut one line through the tubing and make sure you don't cut all the way through or past the ends.
Then seal up the other end, either by gluing it or shrinking it.
After that's done, connect the heat shrink tubing to the clear air pump tubing.
Use latex to attach the heat shrink tubing to your actor's neck. Keep in mind it needs to be completely dry before moving on. While that's drying, unhook the spray gun from your garden sprayer and use the tube connector to connect it to your air pump tubing. Don't be afraid to use zip ties because you don't want any liquid to leak out. Now pour your blood into your garden sprayer and leave it there till it's time to film. Your latex neck mold needs to be secured with more latex onto the actor's neck over the heat shrink tubing that's already there. Once that dries, add more makeup over the latex to blend it into the actor's skin. Once the latex dries, add more makeup to blend it in with your actor's skin. That's our tutorial. Have fun with your blood and gore! Stupid front door is being locked. Stupid teacher making me come in on a Saturday. All I did was break a bottle over the kid's head. He'll be fine. And I mean, yeah, they had to call in the paramedics. But he'll be out of the hospital.